शरण गति सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपिण्यै श्री शारदा देव्यै नमः। ओम नमो नारायणाय। डियर सिस्टर्स, ब्रदर्स एंड लविंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे इज अ ग्लोरियस डे एज वी सेलिब्रेट द 168th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ आवर होली मदर श्री शारदा देवी। We offer our respectful pranams at the feet of most revered Sri Swami Smarananji Maharaj, President of the Worldwide Ramakrishna Mutt and Ramakrishna Mission, and to most revered Sri Swami Gautamananji Maharaj, Vice President of the Ramakrishna Order. Our esteemed Gurujis have very kindly blessed us on this special occasion. Sri Sharda Ma has touched the hearts of millions of devotees throughout the world and continues to do so even today. We are very fortunate to receive messages from our revered Gurujis during this joyous and sacred festival of Holy Mother's Birthday. Later in the program, we will listen to the video message of most revered Swami Gautamananji Maharaj. It is my privilege to read a message dated 17th November 2021 from most revered President Maharaj. I am happy to learn that Sri Sharda Devi Ashrama, Durban, South Africa is going to celebrate Sri Sharda Devi Jayanti. And on this occasion, an online satsang will be organized on Sunday, 26th December 2021. The precious heritage of the great and ideal women of India, of ancient and modern times, found true expression and fulfillment in the life of the Holy Mother. A man or woman, by the conscious, unselfish, and purposeful discharge of his or her respective duties, attains everything. This much-needed message to mankind has been proclaimed by the advent of the Holy Mother, the divine consort of Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna. Holy Mother said, "Everything, no doubt, happens by God's will. Yet man must work because God expresses his will through man's action. If a person renders his duty sincerely and offers its fruit to God, one becomes pure in heart and his desires for worldly things also subside." On another occasion, Holy Mother said, "As long as man has desires, there is no end to his transmigration. It is desires that make him take one body after another. There will be rebirth for a man if he has even the desire to eat a piece of candy." The Katha Upanishad 2.3.14 says the same thing which Holy Mother has said in a very simple way.
यदा सर्वे प्रमुच्यन्ते कामायेस्य हृदि श्रिताः अथ मृत्योऽमृतो भवत् यत्र ब्रह्म समश्नुते.
When all the desires that dwell in the heart fall away, then the mortal becomes immortal and attains Brahman here. May, by the grace of Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother Sri Sharda Devi and Swami Vivekananda, this event be an opportunity for devotees to imbibe the life-giving teachings of Holy Mother Sri Sharda Devi, and may the programs be a grand success. I convey my good wishes to all. Signed by Most Revered Sri Swami Smarananji Maharaj, President of the Ramakrishna Mutt and Ramakrishna Mission.
जय चामुंडया कालिके जय जय जगदम्बा अलका निरंजन है शरण कृपा करो अब अम्बा जय जय काली कपालिनी मातु देहु मोहि शक्ति हाथ जोर विनती करो सहित प्रेम और भक्ति बोलो श्री आदि शक्ति काली माते की जय काली माता जय काली माता
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 काली माता जय काली माता काली माता जय काली माता
काली माता जय काली माता
काली माता जय काली माता
काली माता जय काली माता
कौन जग में माता से प्यारे कौन जग में माता से प्यारे
जग में माता से प्यारे
कौन जग में माता से प्यारे
जग में माता से प्यारे
कौन जग में माता से प्यारे सबसे प्यारी काली माए
सबसे प्यारी काली माए
काली माता जय काली माता
काली माता जय काली माता
है सुख करनी सब दुख हरनी है सुख करनी सब दुख हरनी नर नारी का पालन करनी
नर नारी का पालन करनी
काली माता जय काली माता सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा
मोम लाली सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोम लाली सबसे प्यारी काली माई
सबसे प्यारी
सबसे प्यारे काली माए,
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 सबसे
काली माता,
काली माता जय
काली माता,
काली माता जय
काली माता, जय काली माता,
काली माता जय काली माता,
सुंदर मुकड़ा मोह में लाली,
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 सुंदर मुखड़ा मोह में लाली,
सुंदर मुखड़ा मोह में लाली,
सबसे प्यारी काली माई,
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 काली माता जय काली माता,
काली माता जय काली माता। ओम श्री राम कृष्ण भगवान की जय।
ओम नमो नारायणाय। डियर सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर्स, we are blessed to present a video message by most revered Sri Swami Gautamananji Maharaj. Let us listen to the words of wisdom from our revered Maharaj.
ॐ जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयोः श्रित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः। डियर इष्ट प्राण माताजी एंड डिवोटीज ऑफ श्री शारदा देवी आश्रम डर्बन, टुडे इज द 169th birthday of Holy Mother Sharada Devi. It is the 168th anniversary celebration. It is 169th birthday. We all know that Holy Mother Sharada Devi was born in Jairambati, a distant village in West Bengal, India, on December 22nd of 1853. To the Thursday, and today the whole world knows Jairambati as one of the greatest pilgrimages where the world teacher Sri Sharada Devi was born. You see, we notice in the life of man, man wants immortal life, infinite knowledge and infinite joy. But our human life can give only limited life, limited knowledge and limited joy. This is a fact of life. That is why, however much we must have acquired knowledge, however much long life we might have led, it is only 100 years maximum life for a human being. And the knowledge is so limited. If millions and millions of things are to be known, we hardly know 3 or 4 subjects, and then we think we are all knowledgeable. And joy also, 100 years of joy, assuming that one enjoys the life from the birth to the death and he lives full 100 years of life. Whereas we, the immortal souls, it is inherent in us that we have immortal life. We never are born, we never die. We are immortal souls, part and parcel of God. We are the divine children of God. So God is eternal, we are also eternal. He is immortal, we are also immortal. He is infinite knowledge and we are also infinite knowledge. And He is infinite love and joy. We are also infinite love and joy. As long as our intrinsic nature is this, we cannot be satisfied with these human joys or human knowledge or this short span of human life. This is the fact of life where philosophy starts. So earthly life at some stage gives us a sort of a dissatisfaction that everything here is temporary, is short-lived, but we want something permanent, something lasting. So when this dissatisfaction comes, the real quest for religion starts. It is to initiate into this real quest of religion, that is, to realize our immortal soul or to realize the God inside us. Both mean the same. The God inside us, we call it our Atma, our soul. Our soul and the Supreme Soul are not different. According to the Indian philosophers, our soul, the individual soul, and the infinite or supreme soul, what we call as God or Bhagavan or Brahman, they are one. Aham Brahmasmi, I am the Brahman. So the teachers, spiritual teachers, come into our life and they teach us to realize our real nature, thus remove our dissatisfaction once and for all. So when we thirst for this immortal life and infinite knowledge and infinite bliss in place of the short and temporary life, and then this little joy of this joys of the world and little knowledge, when we get this dissatisfaction towards this, then our mind turns towards the quest of immortality. And when there is a need for us to guide us from a guru comes. Swami Vivekananda has said that whenever there is a want in the economic world, so the want is supplied. Similarly, in the spiritual world also, when a sincere devotee wants the help of a spiritual teacher, he will get him. And the first teacher of such teachers is God Himself. God Himself incarnates as man. He is in appearance man, but in his life, he is an immortal life. He never dies. Jesus never dies. Buddha has never died. Rama or Krishna have never died. Chaitanya has not died. Sri Ram Krishna has not died. They are all alive. They are eternal. So God Himself appears as incarnation. That is how Sri Ramakrishna appeared in this world, to lead the world into a new world of religion. The world had forgotten real religion. real religion according to Sri Ramakrishna is to realize that we are immortal souls, part and parcel of God. Each man is divine, and divine is there in the form of this creation before us, and divine is there in our meditation when we go deep into ourselves. So God is inside, God is outside, and God is everything. So to teach this religion, religion is realization, he said, to see God. If God is there, it is true, we should be able to see. He said, there is a path, I will show you the path. He showed the path. And when he came as an incarnation, he brought also his Shakti, his power in the form of Holy Mother Sharada Devi. So he always, the Lord incarnates, and along with him, his Shakti, his consort also comes. We see Sita in the incarnation of Rama, we see Radha in the incarnation of Krishna. Similarly, all the other incarnations also, the consort comes. So Sri Ramakrishna's consort was Sharada Devi, his spiritual consort. So God himself comes, he has promised in the Bhagavad Gita, Yada Yada Dharmasya Glanir Bhavati Bharata Abhyutthanam Dharmasya Tadatmanam Tajamyam. So he has declared that whenever there is decline of real religion, that means people lose their way and they just move out in darkness to know what real religion is, and they are just engaged with the petty rituals and the externals which can never give them the realization of God. So God himself comes. So this time Sri Ramakrishna has come as the world guru with his Shakti, his consort, Sharada Devi. As I have already said, Sharada Devi is born in an insignificant village in 1853 on December 22, a Thursday. Thursday is the next to Wednesday. On the Wednesday was born Sri Ramakrishna in 1836. And she was born on the next day, the Thursday. So Sri Ramakrishna's consort comes to the world. And Sri Ramakrishna, whatever he taught, he could teach about all his life, almost 44 years of his life, were spent in quest of religion and realizing religion in all its aspects, in the form of, with the God with form, God without form, God beyond both form and formlessness. So in every form, he realized God, and he found out the path to realize God. People of different temperaments require different types of paths. He found out such paths and he revealed it to the world through his teachings for about last 6 years, 1882 to 1886. Or 1881 to 1886, you can say. So he taught for 6 years only. When he left, Sharada Devi was 34 years, and she had to take up the mantle, and she continued his spiritual ministration from another 33 years. At 34 years, she served Sri Ramakrishna by being behind him, and for next 33 years, she came into the open and spread the message of Sri Ramakrishna of real religion, the religion that would confer upon humanity peace, joy, brotherhood, and spiritual knowledge, just like the physical or scientific knowledge. And that because it was based on realization, it is most scientific, most rational. It can stand all the tests of modern science and rationality. So this religion, Sharada Devi taught throughout her life. So we can see today, we will notice tremendous ability of Sharada Devi, how she could impart this one to the common men and women in their life. So, for example, we see she compares equally with Sri Ramakrishna when we see her in Samadhi, in the highest state of God realization. Sri Ramakrishna going to Samadhi, where he would forget his body and mind and would be one with God. He would come down and then reveal secrets of spiritual world. So he used to say, I saw God playing with his consort. I saw God playing with his disciples. So you see spiritual thing, just as we would go to a theater and see a drama and come out and report what we saw. He would reveal truth after truth. That means going into Samadhi means going into the realm of God himself. Enter the realm of God and come back and reveal it to the world. So Sri Ramakrishna's life and teachings are full of such incidences, and Holy Mother was no less than him in this respect. One example we can see in the life of Holy Mother, Swami Sharadananda was her helper. He used to call himself, I am the servant of Holy Mother and I am the gatekeeper of Holy Mother. But he was himself a God-realized soul. He was a disciple of Sri Ramakrishna. But somehow or other, he had the good fortune of serving Holy Mother all her life. And once Holy Mother was also alive, and in the same ashram, her attendant Sharadananda was also there, one of the disciples of Sharadananda. So he asked him, Sir, we see you meditating for long and getting yourself filled with that spirit, and then only you initiate us. You take several minutes, sometimes half an hour or even more. But we see Holy Mother, when people go to her for initiation, we have heard only in minutes. She just takes them in and then she imparts the spiritual instruction with the mantra. How does it happen? She just does it in such a short time. You take such a long time. First, Sharadananda was upset. But to compare me with the incarnation, the consort to the incarnation, that is Sharada Devi, and then he said, look, there is certainly great difference. You see, we have to pray, we have to absorb ourselves into the presence of Sri Ramakrishna, go to his presence and take his orders, and according to his will, we impart with the mantra. It takes quite long time to concentrate our mind. Whereas for Holy Mother, she is always in God. She is there in God. Now and then, you know, she comes down into her body and speaks to all of us. She is always immersed in God. What we call as Sahaja Samadhi, the natural Samadhi. It is not, she doesn't get into Samadhi and get out of Samadhi, but she is there living in Samadhi itself. Always she is in the presence of God. That is why it takes only a minute to know the will of Sri Ramakrishna and she imparts the mantra. So that shows the glory of Holy Mother. She was always in the presence of God, lived in God. And when she spoke, it was not she, but God himself was speaking through her. So similarly, we see the glory of Holy Mother in the statement of her intimate companions. Yoginma was such an intimate companion. So Yoginma always used to be with her. So Yoginma says, I saw Holy Mother completely absorbed in Samadhi. That means leaving the whole body and mind, going beyond both and getting immersed in Parabrahman, the Supreme Brahman. And I saw her four times. Once I saw this, her merged in Samadhi in Balaram Bose's house, and I saw her two times in Vrindavan, in Kala Babu's Kunj, Kala Babu's garden house two times, and then in Nilambar Babu's garden house for the fourth time, I saw, and she hardly met Holy Mother. For a few hours in a day, she would come and stay with her and then go away. If she also has seen four times, means Mother, how many times she has gone into Samadhi, how many times she is back from the Samadhi, we cannot imagine. So this great lady who lived in God came to this world only to carry on the mission of Sri Ramakrishna, her husband. Sri Ramakrishna, just as he trained, there are so many stalwarts like Swami Vivekananda, Swami Brahmananda, to be his mantle bearers, to carry on his message to every being in the world, so that they can get the message of a new religion, which says, see God and believe. It is not only believe, it is seeing God. So, this is the path. Each one has a separate path. They indicated hundreds of paths to hundreds of devotees. That is how the religion of Sri Ramakrishna today has spread all over the world. So, Holy Mother also was one of the messiahs, one of the messengers of Sri Ramakrishna. In fact, Sri Ramakrishna told her, do you think that I am myself doing everything? You will have also to have do much. Mother said, you see, I am an ordinary woman. What can I do? No, you will do much more than me. And his prophecy came true. Sri Ramakrishna taught for 6 years. Holy Mother taught for 34 years after his passing away, 1884 to 1920. So, Holy Mother was a tremendously spiritual person who could take everybody from any level into the highest spiritual knowledge. So, Sri Ramakrishna left his message with Swami Vivekananda and Holy Mother Sharada Devi to spread it all over the world. And Holy Mother initiated so many people out of compassion. The compassion of Holy Mother sometimes appears superior to the compassion of Sri Ramakrishna. Why I say is, so Sri Ramakrishna used to take so many tests before he initiated anybody. But in the Holy Mother's life we see, she just, anybody comes and asks for initiation, asks for spiritual instruction, she is ready to give and then take them to the highest spiritual knowledge. She tells them, now this is your last birth. That means all your sins have been washed away. You have been made pure, and this is your last birth. You will afterwards be one with God, or you will be in the presence of God, no more to come back to this suffering world. She used to tell many of her disciples, boys, girls, women, and sinners also. So she assured freedom from rebirth. And so many were there who received this grace from her. Sri Ramakrishna once, you know, said that, Holy Mother, you are taking care of, Holy Mother was to feed the disciples whom he was training for spiritual life. So once he found she was feeding a little more than what he thought was proper to one of his disciples, he objected, if you feed them more, overfeed them, how will they meditate in the night? I want them to meditate the whole of night so that, you know, they can make quick progress and get into the highest enlightenment. Then she said, you don't have to worry about that. I will take care of their spiritual welfare. See the audacity. Can anyone say that? Sri Ramakrishna is talking about the highest spiritual knowledge, not other knowledge. And only an incarnation can say that. I will take them to the highest spiritual knowledge. And to Sri Ramakrishna, she replies, you don't have to worry about Babu Ram. I will take care of his spiritual welfare. So that was Holy Mother, who stood at the highest level of the spiritual teachers. And Sri Ramakrishna too His compassion to the fallen is proverbial. We see Sri Ramakrishna selecting, picking up one of the worst sinners of the Calcutta society. So Girish Chandra Ghosh, the great dramatist, but a sinner of the worst type, him he took up, and we don't go into the details. And this sinner was raised to the highest level of a saint, where the Girish Chandra Ghosh used to sincerely say, "I was a sinner, Sri Ramakrishna has made me a saint so that I can sit at par with Swami Vivekananda." This is Sri Ramakrishna's miracle. Sri Ramakrishna's miracle is myself, a sinner made into a saint. So that was the compassion of Sri Ramakrishna. Holy Mother also did such miracles in many cases. One lady who had committed a heinous crime, she was afraid, she was ashamed to even enter into the portals of Mother. Staying outside her portal, she was weeping. Holy Mother comes herself, embraces her, and then says, "Come in. You have known what sin is, and you are repenting for it. Don't now. I will initiate you into the divine mantra, and I will take all your sins away. From this moment, you got a new birth. So forget about all of the past. You have got a new life." Who can say this? Only God can say. And Mother says that. Another one foreign lady, she comes to her, and there she go on talking to her long period, and then other devotees of her, so they feel rather perplexed, vexed. See, why this the fallen lady and Holy Mother is talking to her, and day after day that girl lady is coming. Mother is spending quite an amount of time with her. One day, one of the disciples or one of the women devotees, they complained to her, "Mother, you see, you go on talking every day for such a long time with her, and we also come every day. That means she is also in our company for such a long time. So when we go outside, people think that we also belong to her category of fallen women. So we feel ashamed. So you should not meet her." Then Mother gives a very, very significant reply. "Look, she is a fallen woman. Whole society has thrown her away. All relatives have her thrown away. And she is in the street, as it were. And the only companion she has in this world is myself. Do you think that I should leave her? I will be with her. I will give her consolation. And she also feels joy. And this will go on whether you come or not. It is your choice." Nobody stopped coming. Everybody came. And this woman was also saved. Out of the compassion on a fallen woman. So similarly, number of compassionate incidents are there in Holy Mother. And Sri Ramakrishna, I have told you about, is making Girish Chandra Ghosh a sinner into a saint. He used to go to his theatre, and other there will be theatre, the other actors and actresses, he would bless them also. So Holy Mother continued that great act of compassion after passing away of Sri Ramakrishna. Being a woman, she would go and attend the theatrical performance of Girish Ghosh, and see, of course, that the most of the dramas were all divine themed. The themes were all divine themes, but yet a woman to go to bless the sinners there. Almost all the actresses and actresses were not of good fame. They had ill fame. Mother had compassion on them. She went, once she saw a divine play of Ramanuja's life, is a great philosopher, Ramanuja, philosopher saint, and she embraced that actress because of her acting the Ramanuja's. And feeling was that she appeared just a real saint Ramanuja to see Holy Mother. So Holy Mother's eyes were so pure, life was so pure, she could raise everybody to her level of purity. So this compassion of Holy Mother is proverbial, and it is for that we worship her today. Nobody need feel hesitation to go to her. She is so simple. She so welcomes everyone. So one young disciple once went to her and then said, "My mind is full of restlessness, full of trash, thoughts of lust, etc. comes and disturbs me. So I don't deserve to be your disciple. So this is the last salute." Then he saluted her and tried to walk away. Then Holy Mother followed him, stopped him and said, "Look at me." And he looked back and saw the compassionate eyes of the mother. He was so much impressed, so much of compassion on me. Then Holy Mother told him, "If lustful thoughts or evil thoughts come into your mind, don't be afraid. Face them. Think of me," she told him. And then she came back. And this young man went on in his path to reach his home. Maybe after an hour he reached his home. All the way he was thinking about the compassionate eyes of mother and her teaching. "Think of me. And lustful thoughts come, evil thoughts come, don't be afraid, face them. How to face them? Think about me." And he was thinking for 1 hour. When he reached the home, all the evil thoughts had left. Then he continued, and then after a few days, he felt himself so pure, he went and offered himself as a brahmachari at the Belur Mutt, where no other than Swami Brahmanandaji, the spiritual son of Sri Ramakrishna, was the head. He gave him shelter. That young man became a great Swami called Tarakeshwarananda. That was the Holy Mother's miracle. Her life was so pure. It was a burning holy fire. It would destroy all the impurities and give purity to anything. So that was Holy Mother's life. We are fortunate today that we could recount some of the great incidents of her life. May Holy Mother grant us her compassionate love and bless us all with the fulfillment of our life, that is, realization of God. That is, in other words, realization of our own immortal life, infinite knowledge and infinite love. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Jai Maa Shakti.
Om Namo Narayanaya, dear sisters and brothers, we have been blessed to listen to the important messages of our revered Gurujis on this happy occasion. They have filled our hearts with peace and joy. We pray that they continue to shower their unconditional love and blessings upon us and guide us towards the goal supreme. Let us meditate on the radiant and serene form of our Holy Mother, Sri Sharda Devi. Mother's life and teachings fill us with inner strength and encourage us to face our challenges, knowing that God is always with us. A verse in praise of Mother Sharda says, O be in the form of my mind, give up sitting on the flowers of worldly pleasures and sip the honey from the lotus of mother's feet for getting rid of the disease of this world. O Sri Sharda Devi, the mother of the universe, I offer my salutations to you. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Om Sarve Sham Swasti Bhavatu, Sarve Sham Shanti Bhavatu, Sarve Sham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarve Sham Mangalam Bhavatu, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschid Dukha Bhag Bhavet. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudakshyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat.
Jai Shri Guru Maharaj Ki Jai. Mahamai Ki Jai. Swami Ji Maharaj Ki Jai. Ganga Mat Ki Jai. Mahavir Swami Ji Ki Jai. Sarvarishi Muniyo Ki Jai.
Parvati Patay Hara Hara.